we have two brilliant new OpenType font formats available in Photoshop CC 2018. One of them is called Variable Font, and the other one is another category called SVG Fonts. So I'm going to show you these in this video. First of all, I have an example here for the Variable Fonts, and I'm going to select this layer here, which is a text layer, your journey. And notice that already here on the right side in the Properties panel, we have these new options that we haven't had before, like the weight, the width, and the slant. Now these will come up only if you select a variable font. At the moment, we only have a few of these fonts available that are automatically going to be installed with the latest version of Photoshop. But in the future, Adobe promises to have more of these fonts available. And because it's completely new technology, it's going to be rare to find them, but I believe they will be huge. And most of the famous font creator companies, I'm sure, are going to invest in producing these for us. So the one I'm going to use for this demonstration is called Ecumen Variable Concept. Now, once I select that, we can see that we have these controls that we don't normally have for other fonts. And with these, we can change these values easily. So instead of going through the different options, like for bold and italic, we just change the weight of the font, which changes from the ultra thin to the bold or black. And then we also have width, which will widen or condense the fonts. So this is what we would normally call extra condensed and ultra black, because we have it extremely narrow, the characters, but they are really strong and bold, which we normally call black or ultra black. And that's actually something you can already see here in the description. Now, if I click on this, you can see to be able to generate these different looks for our font, there has to be a lot of variations to choose from. And the reason why it was necessary to have these controls is to make it easier to find the right version that we are looking for instead of scrolling through this huge list. So it makes it much easier to work with these values and controls. So for example, now if I want it a little bit more wider and maybe a little bit less bulky, I can set that up very quickly. But then if I want to add a little bit of slant, which means like make it more italic, I can also decide exactly the angle of the italic property by using the slant value, which is the third one. So you can see how quickly and easily we managed to set up what we needed. And the cool thing is that you can even select multiple text layers now in Photoshop and change their values at the same time. Now, if their values are different, then obviously it won't be available to change it. But if I revert back to the original font that we used there and then just update it to the values that we decided to work with, you can see I can change both of the fonts at the same time, even if their size are different. So these are variable fonts. Now let me show you what the SVG font looks like. Again, that's something I favorited, so I can find it quickly. And that's one of the examples, the Trajan color, or Trajan color, I don't actually know how to pronounce this properly, but this is the one that we can have a closer look at if I increase its size. The cool thing about SVG fonts is that this is actually not a layer style, this is a graphic font, so it means that each of the glyphs are actual SVG vector graphics. And when I highlight one of the characters, I can even see the different variations. So we even have different colors available if we want to access them. So if I select this word here again, just like before, and I keep hovering over this, I can change the color of each of the characters very quickly. So these are all individual glyphs. And of course, it's still editable text. So if I want, for example, to reduce the kerning, I can select all of these and alt left and right arrows like we would normally do it, and so on and so forth. You can imagine it is still a working text without any layer styles on it, but still looks more three-dimensional, and it has gradients and multiple colors, thanks to the fact that each of the glyphs are individual vector graphics. Once again, there's not many of these SVG fonts yet available, but again, I'm sure we will see more of these, and they will be brilliant for more advanced decorative fonts like emojis and icon sets that we can use in our Photoshop projects. So to find these new type of fonts in Photoshop, look for the icons with VAR on them for the variable fonts and SVG icon for the vector graphic based fonts. Have fun exploring these new ways of working with typography and keep an eye out for new SVG and variable fonts released in the future.